Welcome to the course of Mechanical System Design, in which we are learning about design of cylinders and pressure vessels. In the last lecture, we learned about design of main shell of a pressure vessel, and in this lecture, we will learn about design of enclosures. Various types of enclosures or heads are used in pressure vessel. We will be discussing four most popular heads used in the industry. Heads are of two types. First one is the flat head and the second one is the formed head, which are made up of forming process. Out of formed heads, we will be discussing three types of heads called as hemispherical head, semi-elliptical head and torispherical head. The formula for thickness of these heads is presented in this slide. Along with the formula of thickness, the formula of volume contained inside this head is also given for reference, which is function of internal diameter DI. As the name suggests, hemispherical head is hemispherical in the shape. Semi-elliptical head looks like half of the ellipse, which is cut along the major axis of the ellipse. It should be noted that this is a special ellipse in which the major axis is twice as that of length of the minor axis of the ellipse. In order to understand the construction of torispherical head, first we have to understand what is meant by a torus. If a sphere is cut into two equal halves, then one of the halves is called as hemisphere. However, if the sphere is cut into two unequal halves, then the smaller part is called as a torus. Thus, the torispherical head looks like a torus and introduces an additional dimension called as crown radius, denoted by RC. The hemispherical head is smoothly merged with the main shell by giving a sharp radius at the end, which is called as knuckle radius. In all these formed heads, an additional dimension SF can be seen in the diagram. This is the straight portion provided at the end of each type of head so that it smoothly matches with the main shell of the pressure vessel. The dimension SF is calculated by the formula 3 times thickness of the head or 30 mm, whichever is higher. A close observation of the diagram of all three formed heads will reveal that the hemispherical head is the deepest head, whereas torispherical head is the shallowest head. The depth of the semi-elliptical head lies between hemispherical head and torispherical head. The relative advantages and disadvantages can be seen by solving a numerical example. A cylindrical pressure vessel shell of inside diameter 1500 mm is subjected to an internal pressure of 2 MPa. The shell and heads are made of low alloy steel with ultimate tensile strength of 450 Nm/mm². The double welded butt joints, which are spot radiographed, are used to fabricate the vessel. The corrosion allowance is 3 mm. Determine the thickness of cylindrical shell and head if heads are flat, torispherical with crown radius 1125 mm, semi-elliptical with ratio of major axis to minor axis as 2, and hemispherical. The given data can be extracted from the problem statement as follows. Internal diameter 1500 mm. Design pressure is taken as 2.1 MPa. It should be noted that the internal pressure is 2 MPa, but as we have seen in the last lecture, we have to consider the design pressure, which is 1.05 times the internal pressure. Hence, the design pressure is 2.1 MPa. The weld joint efficiency eta is considered as 85%. Since the vessel is double welded butt joint and spot radiography is performed, we have to refer to the weld joint efficiency table we have seen in the last lecture, and we can identify that the weld joint efficiency is 85% for this combination. First, we have to design the cylindrical shell given by the formula, and the thickness of the cylindrical shell comes out to be 15.45 mm. Now, since the vessel is made up of standard sheets or plates available in the market, we have to round it off to the next integer, which is 16 mm. All four thickness of a heads can be calculated by using the formulae discussed in the previous slide and reproduced over here for the convenience. A close observation of all the answers will reveal that flat head leads to the highest thickness of the head, and hemispherical head results into the smallest thickness of the head, which indicates that there is lot of saving of material in case of hemispherical head. And as far as material cost is concerned, hemispherical head is the preferred one. However, it can also be argued that as far as manufacturing cost is concerned, flat head is the best option. Among the formed heads, torusospherical head is the shallowest head, whereas hemispherical head is the deepest head. Therefore, the manufacturing cost of torusospherical head will be lesser as compared to the hemispherical head. So, in totality, considering the cost of manufacturing and cost of material, torusospherical head seeks the best balance, and therefore it is the most popular type of head used in the pressure vessels. Thank you.